Hello. Bastard. Well, Trapper relies on his bear traps for a solid portion of the game. Most of the early game will be spent attempting to place bear traps in solid areas that you can feel survivors might walk into. These areas are best near the vault points or in tall grass by generators. Survivors tend to do a weird teleport thing when using pallets, making it a little wonky to put by pallets, but vaulting always gives you a solid snag, and so does hiding them in the grass. Past that, you have some of the best base stats of any killer, so you'll be chasing them quite a lot. Pallets are going to be your biggest issue, but like most killers, break the ones that are safe and ignore the unsafe ones. Trappy Boy is a fast-ass bitch, so keep running, keep slapping survivors. If you can, herd them into your traps to minimize your time chasing as well. That's the whole point of the Trapper. Most of the time, you're not going to get a survivor accidentally stepping in your traps. It'll happen occasionally, but unless you're chasing them, there's a good chance it won't happen. The Trapper is the best at going ahead and herding a survivor towards a vault point that they have to use and stepping in the trap right there. You get some extra points, you get to pick them up immediately, and then boom, on the hook they go. Speaking of hooks, when it comes to hooking survivors, most hooks have a vault point near it where you can place a trap. Putting the trap on that point is your best bet because placing them all around the feet of them makes it way too obvious and can be easily removed, but if there's no vault point, you can probably just find a route used to save the hook survivor and put it there, and either just roll the dice that they'll run that direction specifically, or herd them into it. So in conclusion, set up traps, beat the survivors like your meat on December 1st, and herd them into the traps for maximum snappy. For the Trapper's add-ons, the four you want the most are what makes setting traps faster, more difficult to see, carry more, or the two main stones. Trapper gloves, trap setters, and setting tools for the speed, logwood dye in the tar bottle for the stealth, trapper bag in the stitched bag for the extra traps, and the honing and diamond stone for a large amount of bullshit. The teachable perks we have are Oh No, I Dropped the Soap, Yummy Yummy Pallets in My Tummy, and the CrossFit Workout. Now, agitation and brutal strength are definitely worth picking up. Unnerving presence is, it's okay sometimes, but generally not very worth it. The other two, however, I highly recommend. Standard perk builds for the killer include one for tracking, one for hooks, one for generators, and one for situations. Whispers is a good choice because it's an amazing tracking perk in general, but also if you have the Whispers going, you know, don't set a trap right now because Sabo Jake is around the corner jerking off, ready to destroy it. Agitation is excellent for getting people to the hook faster. It's really good on all killers. Next up, you want Overcharge or Hex Ruin. Overcharge is already a great perk, but Hex Ruin is actually surprisingly good on the Trapper for two reasons. Number one is it slows down the early game, so all the time you spend placing traps won't be wasted, and also, if you're lucky enough that the Hex isn't in a horrible position, you can actually trap around the Hex to bait them. Finally, I like to run either Brutal Strength or Enduring for pallets, Barbecue and Chili for points or tracking, and Franklin's Demise for flashlights. But if you want to be a trappy meme, you go Hex Ruin, Hex Thrill the Hunt, Hex Devour Hope, and Overcharge, because trapping every Hex on the map never felt so good. And with that, this has been our guide on Evan McMillan, the Trapper and the Trappy Boy. As a reminder to all my killer friends, this game is played how you want to play it. You can do whatever you feel like, no made-up rules, no made-up honor code, no made-up anything should tell you how to play your killer. Be the master of your own game, and most of all, have fun. My name has been Bricky, and liking traps isn't gay, but stepping in them is. Bye-bye.
Oh, whoops.
Well, what a wonderful... thick and fog day to you, survivor stabbing the shit out of my back. My name is Bricky. Welcome to the sixth installment of the Dead by Daylight case file featuring the hag, or better known as the Slappy Girl. If you didn't know why she's the Slappy Girl, it's because the way she breaks gens and pallets, she's all like... The hag's real name is Elisa Sherwood, who grew up in a small village away from the world with elders, old school teachings, you know, carvings, emblems, all the like. Walking home one day, a massive storm began to brew and she lost her way. Stumbling through a swamp, she lost her footing and knocked her head on one big-ass rock. Slipping in and out of consciousness, dark shapes dragged her away and she awoke chained in a cellar. With her, many other captured people with massive open wounds all throughout them. Cannibalized.
Don't touch it. Yo. Wait a second.
Yeah! Yeah!
Oh. Hey, Dad.
Thank you.
Hey, Dad. It's just me.